There are really three subjects that we are not allowed to talk about as human beings today. Those are religion, politics, and money. And with the first two, I sort of understand it. I mean, religion and politics are inherently divisive and they bring a lot of negative energy as far as conversations go today. But money, number three, I don't understand that one at all. We should all love talking about money, but sort of when I think back, a few years ago, I had a lot of insecurities about money and I certainly wasn't able to communicate effectively about it. And if you find yourself in that same situation, then I would highly recommend checking out this book right here, Time, Money, Freedom by Ray and Jessica Higdon. I love this book. This book provides 10 simple rules to redefine what's possible and radically reshape your life. These rules are meant to take you from where you are today to where you'd like to be in the future. This book is not about radically overhauling everything that you have going on in your life, quitting your job today and just starting a business and becoming a millionaire, but it can do those things for you over time. What it provides you is small, simple steps that, when taken over a long period of time, can lead to that sort of disproportionately positive outcome that we all want. And so I wish I had read it in the past because I had a lot of insecurities about money. There are two rules that I'd like to mention today, sort of give you a preview to see whether or not this book would be a good fit for you. Rule number two is called pluck your weeds. Where you currently stand today, you probably have a few things that are holding you back. They're limiting your potential. Maybe that's a negative health habit that you need to kick. Maybe it's a problem with your investing strategy. Maybe it's a couple negative people in your circle of five that are holding you back and casting shade and doubt on you all the time. What this book does is it helps you reflect on those things. Ray and Jessica have a couple action items in this book, and one of them calls you to sit down and look at your current obstacles and journal about them, write about them, reflect about them, spend some time thinking about them. And then when you identify a weed, maybe, like I said, it's a negative health habit, maybe it's a problem with your investing strategies, maybe it's a negative friend that you keep around too much and speak to too much, it's all that gossip and negativity, you need to pluck those weeds and toss them to the side. This book will help you to identify those weeds, and it's not just those three categories I mentioned, it's any area in your life. You're going to have weeds that are limiting your potential. A book like this can help you find them with precision accuracy, identify them, and then give you the tools and strategies to rip them out and replace them with more positive opportunities for growth. Plucking your weeds is a really good metaphor. It's sort of like burning your negative bridges, as Trent Shelton would say. So that was one of my favorite rules. The other one that I'd like to expand on in a little bit more detail is rule number four, change your relationship with money. Ray and Jessica, when they were first starting their relationship, or actually kind of even far into their relationship, they realized that they had some uneven expectations with money. See, Ray looked at money as an opportunity to invest and grow and have fun and expand and be free. And Jessica, she looked at money as security because she had come from a little bit of a rockier situation growing up, and she thought the more money we have, the more secure we can be. And so as the bank account was getting lower because Ray was investing money, Jessica would say things like, hey, I'm feeling a little bit insecure about our bank account. I don't think you should be spending so much. And Ray would hear into his ear, hey, you're not providing enough for our family. You're not a man and things like that. And so they just came from different places. This book provides you strategies and conversation topics and ways to phrase your communication to sort of address problems like that in a relationship or by yourself. Give you the tools to move forward and make better decisions with your money. Change your relationship with it. Like I said, I used to be really insecure with my money. When I was late teens, early 20s, I was getting a business degree. And that meant that I was around a lot of people who were pretty fluent in the conversations surrounding money and investing and trading and in entrepreneurship and things like that. But I didn't know any better. I wasn't very fluent with those topics and those conversations. So if I was in a circle of people talking about investing or talking about how much money we were going to make out of school, I would sort of shy back, fold my arms, try to avoid getting called on because I didn't want to be embarrassed. I didn't understand it. But over time, after reading a couple of really good books about money, not only did I understand it, but I became conversationally fluent. And now here I am thinking religion, politics, money. One doesn't stick out. It's money. I love talking about money. And you know what? Like I said in the beginning of the video, money puts food on the table and it puts shelter above your head. It also provides you the opportunity to be free. As Tim Ferriss says in The 4-Hour Workweek, which is one of my favorite books, the new rich, they don't care about how much money's in the bank. They care about time and mobility and freedom. Those are the things that I care about. And you know what? Those require money. There are certain ways to limit the amount of money you're spending, but they require money. Money gives you the opportunity to be more happy. No, money doesn't equal happiness, but it does provide you an opportunity to be more happy than you are today because it provides freedom and flexibility. So change your relationship with money. Read this book. Ray will prompt you to go through and reflect on your existing portfolio and think about adding professionals. He has conversation topics, Ray and Jessica do. It'll prompt you to be a little bit more fluent than you are today. These 10 rules can take you from where you are now to where you'd like to be in the future if you give them a shot. I would highly recommend checking out this book right here, Time, Money, Freedom by Ray and Jessica Higdon. If you've read it, please comment down below. Let me know what you think. If you follow either one of them, then let us know what you think about the authors. If you don't, I'd recommend following them. They post some pretty cool content. And with that, I'm going to go implement a little bit of what I learned from this book. Go read something. Bye.